What's going on, gamers? If you are starting to see lag or server crashes in your Minecraft server, today we are going to go over what that means and how to fix it. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Whether you own your own server or you play on somebody else's, server owners want you to have tons of fun on your Minecraft server. And to do that, a lot of them add mods or plugins to their server. Hosting a Minecraft server requires allocated memory, which is used for all in-game activities. Sadly, having too many activities can actually decrease the server's performance for all of its players. Having too many mods installed will start to overload the server, causing crashes and lagging. All server owners want a smooth, enjoyable experience, so learning what causes a server to overload will help prevent and resolve any tick lag. Let's go through some of the causes so that you can take control to protect your server from crashes. All Minecraft servers, whether modded or vanilla, use ticks per second, or TPS, for operations like movement, breaking and placing blocks, generating chunks, and everything else. The can't keep up console message indicates tick lag, which is caused by in-game activities. If you see that message, the server will most likely not meet the perfect TPS value. The lower value, the more lag you'll experience, and the higher the value, the less. If you get this message, this is what it might look like in the console. The ticks are not determined by the server's allocated memory or the size of the world, but rather the activities in-game. Some of these activities are noticeable, but other times they can be difficult to detect. There are many ways a server can become laggy and overloaded, so it's ideal to understand what might be causing them before trying to fix them. Sometimes, many Minecraft players seek to create many mob farms and other types of grinders. However, making too many farms can actually result in server lag, especially in the same region or chunk. Other entities might be item frames, armor stands, and minecarts. In other words, having too many mobs and entities in the server may cause the world to overload. Experienced players in Minecraft might use an automatic machine, but having too many of them in the world, especially in the same region or chunk, will impact the server's performance. Removing or limiting their use would be optimal for performance. Remember, the tick rate on the server controls the world operations, and having too many activities at once might be causing a reduction in the TPS. If you've looked and you have minimal mob farms, entities, and machines, but you're still experiencing lag, then the server settings are most likely the cause. There are a ton of options for bucket-based and modded servers, so it can be difficult to know which ones help with performance. Typically, the settings relating to entities, chunks, and redstone are the ones to check first. Now that you know how servers overload and what that means, managing your server will be easier to understand. Of course, you want to make sure that players have a safe and reliable connection to the server without interruption caused by tick lag. Limiting farms, machines, and other entities combined with tweaking the settings will improve your server's performance. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.